Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome to my channel where I share tips and tricks on React Native development. In this video, I am going to talk about one of the core concepts of React Native, state. State is a JavaScript object that holds some data that can change over time in your React Native components. For example, you might have a state that stores the number of times a user presses a button or the name of a user that they enter in a text input. State allows you to create dynamic and interactive UIs that respond to user actions and events. Whenever you change the state of a component, React Native will automatically re-render the component and its children with the updated data. So how do we use state in React Native? Well, there are two ways to define and manage state depending on whether you are using function components or class components. If you are using function components, which are recommended by the React team, you can use the useState hook to create and update state. The useState hook takes an initial value for your state and returns an array with two elements, the current state value and a setter state that you can use to update the state. For example, let's say we want to create a simple app that shows a random joke every time a user presses a button. We can use the useState hook to create a state variable called joke and initialize it with empty string. Then we can use the setter function called setJoke to fetch a joke from an API and update the joke state with the response. Here is what the code looks like. If you are using class components, which are an older way of writing React components, you can use the constructor and this.state to initialize your state object. Then you can use this.setState method to update your state object with new values. The code for the same joke app using class component would look something like this. As you can see, both function components and class components can use state to store and update data. However, function components are simpler and more concise, and they also have access to other hooks that makes working with state easier. One thing to note is that whenever you update the state of a component, React Native will re-render the component and its children with the new state data. This means that your UI will always reflect the latest state changes. However, there are some best practices that you should follow when using state. First, avoid directly mutating your state object. Instead of modifying your state object directly, such as this.state.joke equals 3. Use this.setState or the setter function to create a new object with the updated values. This will ensure that React Native knows when to re-render your component and avoid bugs. Second, keep your state minimal and local. Only store data that is relevant for your component's re-rendering and logic in your state object. Avoid storing derived data that can be computed from other sources. Also, keep your state as close as possible to where it is used. If some data is only used by one child component, don't store it in the parent component's state. Instead, let the child component manage its own state. Third, use a state container like Redux for complex state management. If your app has many components that share and sync state across different screens or features, you might find it hard to manage your state using only React Native's built-in state mechanism. In that case, you can use a state container like Redux to create a centralized and predictable state management system for your app. These libraries provide tools and patterns to organize your state data and logic in a scalable and maintainable way. That's it for this video on React Native State. I hope you learned something useful and enjoyed watching. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more React Native content. Also, feel free to leave a comment below if you have any questions or feedback. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.